Hi, this is a tutorial for Google Classroom for beginners. This is really designed for people who have never used Google Classroom at all before. We did this webinar live, but this is just the tutorial that you can start and stop as you are working through your very first Google Classroom. So I'm Nancy Watson. I'm one of the consultants for Region 10's digital learning team. We're going to jump right in, and I'm going to help you lead from where you are with Google Classroom. To get to Google Classroom, there's at least a couple of ways to get there. One of them is to go to classroom.google.com and just type that into your browser's address bar. Or you can open a new tab in Chrome, click the waffle at the top right next to your picture, and then click the classroom icon. Once you're in, you'll see something like this, but if you have never logged into Google Classroom before, your screen will look a little bit different. You won't have the tiles with the classroom titles on them, for example. If you are asked to choose whether you are a student or a teacher, be sure to click Teacher. That's very important because if at any point in the past you have selected that you are a student, you will not see both of these icons. You won't have the option to create a class. If you are only seeing the option to join class, it means that Google Classroom is seeing you as a student. The only person who can untangle that for you is whoever is in a position at your campus or district to manage the Google console. It's usually some IT person, and you'll just need to send them an email or give them a call and tell them that you are in as a student and that you need to be designated as a teacher in Google Classroom. If you do see both options, you're going to click Create Class, and then you'll have the option to name your class. Notice that the only field that is required on this page is the class name. So you might just put a practice class if you want to. If you want to jump right in with the name of your class, that's totally fine. When you have this filled out the way you like, click Create at the bottom right of that square. Then you'll come into your newly created Google Classroom. Notice that there are several areas of the classroom. The first area that you come to is called the stream, and this is where you can communicate messages to your class. At the right of the picture, you'll see that you have the option to select a theme or upload your own photo. This is the theme that Google Classroom selected for me. Usually it's kind of intuitive, and if you have named your class something with the word science in it, for example, you might get a header image that looks like science stuff. The class code shows up over here on the left side of your header image. And when you click on the small square, you can expand that to be able to show that to your students. This is helpful if you are in class and you're displaying this on your projector, but it also might help just to see this a little bit bigger. The second area of Google Classroom is your classwork page. This is where you will create assignments, and we'll get into that in just a little bit. Google Classroom does a really nice thing for you, a couple of things. It will automatically put assignments that have a due date onto your Google Calendar and also onto your students' Google Calendar. So if your students have, say, 6 different Google Classrooms that their teachers are using, each one of those teachers' assignments will go onto the student's calendar. Additionally, Google Classroom will create for you a class drive folder that looks kind of like this. You can see that in my drive, there is a big folder called Classroom, and then there is a folder for each of the Google Classrooms that I have created. Within each of those Google Classrooms, it will create subfolders for each of the assignments that you create. That is on your classroom, and it is also on your student's classroom. One other cool feature about these folders is that you can see your students' work in progress when you go into each individual assignment folder. The next portion of your Google Classroom is the people area. You can add teachers to be co-teachers with you in your Google Classroom. You can add students by their email address, or you can give them the class code, which is repeated there at the bottom. It's a lot easier to give your students the code than it is to enter names one at a time, especially if you are working with secondary where you have lots and lots of students. We're not going to look at grades at all in this particular webinar. Finally, over at the top right, you will see a gear. When you click the gear, that takes you to the settings menu. The first thing you'll see in the settings menu is that class details. This should look familiar because you entered your class name just a minute ago, and it looks similar to this. If you change your name of your class, you can do that here, and you can add the other things like the class description and the section and that kind of thing. The next setting of the settings area is general. This is where you can see once again your class code. If you get an ambiguous character in your class code, like maybe a numeral 1 that is difficult to distinguish, whether it's a 1 or a capital I or a lowercase l, you can reset that code so that it has less ambiguous characters. You can also choose to display it from this area. You can copy it so that you could send it out in an email, or you can disable it so that no additional students can get into your classroom with that code. The next thing that's very important is for where you can set on the stream who can contribute to the conversations. The default setting for this is that students can post and comment. You'll probably want to change that, at least at first, to only teachers can post or comment until you've had a chance to talk to your students about what an appropriate online conversation looks like. This is a behavior management issue, and it's also a digital citizenship issue. So for now, if you have not ever had the opportunity to engage in online discussions with your students, I would definitely recommend changing that at first to only teachers can post or comment. Back in the classwork area, we're now going to look at creating your first assignment. Note that when you click on the blue Create button, you have the option to create an assignment, a quiz assignment, a question, or material. Material would be like a syllabus or a calendar, something that the students would just look at. Reusing a post means going back to find a previous post. I'm assuming that since this is a very beginner class that you won't need that. We're only going to take a look at the assignment creation today. When you click on assignment, you can give your assignment a title. I'm just practicing, so I'm calling mine My First Assignment. Notice that when you click on Add at the the bottom of that section, you have the option to add something from your Google Drive, a link, a file, or a YouTube video. If you choose to add something from your Drive, this is when the magic of Google Classroom really becomes apparent, because you can choose to add from your Drive as three different types of file for the student. The first is that students can view the file. This means that they would just be able to look at it, and they would have to make their own copy if they wanted to add to it or edit that file in any way. The second option is students can edit the file. That means all students who have been assigned this file can edit the same document. That it's not very often that you would use that particular option. The last one is the one that you'll probably use the most often, and that is to make a copy for each student. That will put an individual copy of your file in each student's Google Drive, and it will also put the student's name at the top in the file name. When you are making the assignment, notice that on the right side, you have the option to assign to just the class that you're working in or to any other Google Classroom that you've created. This is really helpful if, for example, you are a secondary teacher and you have four or five sections of the same Google Classroom subject. You can automatically assign just by checking boxes which of your classes will receive that assignment. Additionally, you can choose to see which students from a class will get that particular assignment. For example, when I click on all students, I can leave it at all students, or I can assign it to specific students. This is a great way to differentiate. I might have three different versions of the same assignment, and I can assign each version to the student who needs that particular version, and no student would ever be aware that they might have a slightly different version from someone else. Finally, at the top right, when you're ready to assign, you can click the blue assign button, or if you're not quite ready, and you'd like to maybe do some more editing, you have some options from that drop-down menu. Those are to go ahead and assign it now, schedule it for later, which is helpful if you're trying to plan ahead a little bit, save the draft if you want to go back and add to it later or edit it in any way, or you can discard the draft. That is it for how to create your first assignment. There's a lot more to Google Classroom, but for a beginner lesson, that's all we're going to cover today. Some suggestions: please start small. You don't have to learn everything there is to know about Google Classroom at once. If you do choose to have those classroom discussions, talk to your students ahead of time and help them collaborate on the agreements that you would like to have for your class for those online interactions, and maybe have them decide what the consequences would be if someone violates those classroom norms. And finally, ask us for help if you get stuck. Again, my name is Nancy Watson, and that's my email address, nancy.watson@region10.org. You can also reach out to Misty Trevino, misty.trevino@region10.org, and Catherine Laster, catherine.laster@region10.org. We are here to help you, and we hope that you will reach out to us and let us know what we can do to support you in this very unusual time that we're all experiencing. Additional resources are available to you at this website, and we hope to see you soon.